Thank you. The next item of business is consideration of business motion 13118 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau on changes to the business programme. Any member who wishes to speak against the motion should press their request to speak button now. And I call on George Adam to move the motion.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I'm moved.
Thank you, Minister. And I call on Douglas Ross to speak to and move Amendment 13118.1. Up to 5 minutes, Mr Ross.
Thank you very much, Presiding Officer. Exactly a week ago, I stood here and asked the Scottish Government, now a minority in this Parliament, to work with others to seek just one thing. For us to stay behind by just 30 extra minutes last Tuesday to get an urgent statement from the Lord Advocate. SNP and Green members last week voted that down. I hope this week they will support it, because this is a genuine request to get an update from not just the head of the Crown Office and Procurator Fiscal Service in Scotland, but a member of the Scottish Government Cabinet. We last heard from the Lord Advocate in January. She made a statement to Parliament and was questioned by MSPs. During that statement, she was clear that exonerating everyone, a mass exoneration of everyone convicted under the Horizon scandal, was not, in her view, the correct course of action. We are now into May, and we still don't know if that is the current and still held view of the Lord Advocate, or if her opinion has changed. We now know that in just a matter of weeks, this Parliament will be asked on the 21st of May to debate and vote on stage one of the Scottish Horizon legislation here in Holyrood. The next day, on the 22nd of May, we will debate stage two as a committee of this entire Parliament. How can we go into that important legislative process without knowing the position of the most senior law officer in Scotland? Last week, when I raised this issue, George Adam responding said, "There is no clarity needed. The Scottish Government has repeatedly made clear its position that proposed legislation on the Horizon scandal, etc., etc." What is not clear is if the Lord Advocate agrees with the position of the Scottish Government. I don't think it's too much for this Parliament to ask for the Lord Advocate to come to this chamber to outline her position and answer questions about it. We know there are questions due this week at First Minister's Questions. Polly McNeill has a question on this issue at First Minister's Questions. And I will give way to Polly McNeill, but that shows how important it is across the parties that we get a response on this issue. And I'll give way to Polly McNeill.
Polly McNeill.
Thank you to Douglas Ross for giving way. The member will be aware there was a 5-year period in which the suspicions about Horizon Systems were known, and also be aware that no victims were contacted that had previously been prosecuted. Does the member agree that, given the actions of Crown Office, who should have known that through the Second Sight report that there were system flaws, that the Crown Office should be fully accountable for those actions to this Parliament, and Labour are happy to support this amendment to the business motion today?
Douglas Ross.
I very much welcome that support from Pauline McNeill and the support we got from Labour and the Liberal Democrats last week. And I will be listening with interest to her question and the responses on Thursday. But is it really too much to ask for this Parliament to sit for an additional 30 minutes tonight? Indeed, I think we might even finish early this evening. Is 30 minutes too much to ask to allow sub-postmasters in our constituencies and regions across Scotland to hear from the Lord Advocate, to hear if she still does not believe that mass exoneration is the right approach, or if she thinks that is now the correct approach and has advised so for the legislation coming up in just a couple of weeks' time? I'm encouraged that the SNP want to work across the political spectrum. I was disappointed 7 days ago that they voted down this reasonable amendment to the business motion. I hope today they will reconsider. They will vote with other parties in this Parliament to hear from the Lord Advocate, to allow that scrutiny from Parliament, and importantly, to give the answers our sub-postmasters not only need, that absolutely deserve. I move the amendment in my name.
Thank you, and I call on George Adam to respond on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Presiding Officer, as I said last week, the most important individuals and people in this are the families and people that suffered because of the decisions made by the Post Office, and I think that's what we must all think of when we're dealing with this issue in particular. And I mentioned last week that's the reason why we are looking at doing legislation, so that we can ensure that they have that protection and they know that the horror of what's happened to them has come to an end. Bureau is aware that there are important protocols that must be followed in terms of introduction of legislation. And following the period of pre-introduction scrutiny, the bill is expected to be introduced on the 14th of May and published by Parliament on the 15th of May. Current expectations are that Stage 1 will be on the 21st of May and Stage 2 on the 22nd of May. And this will allow MSPs any opportunity to see the terms of the Scottish Bill ahead of Stage 1. And it will be down the process Mr Ross mentioned.
Douglas Ross.
I'm grateful to the Minister for giving way. Given that important process is now just a matter of weeks away, can he confirm that this Parliament will hear from the Lord Advocate before that bill is introduced, to allow us for the first time since January to understand if she still believes that there should be no mass exoneration of sub-postmasters, or if she has changed her mind?
Minister.
I appreciate the tone that Mr Ross is taking this week, and I will say to Mr Ross that once again we have to think of the families outside of this place that are dealing with this, want to know that we are going to actually create the legislation to make that difference, to make that change, to bring an end to some of the issues. So the Stage 3, as I said, will follow as soon as the UK Bill is finalised, so that any changes to the Bill can be considered and, where appropriate, reflected in the Scottish Bill. Timing will be kept under review given the uncertainty around the timing of the UK Bill, but it's important for me, Presiding Officer, that everybody knows that we will have the process to be able to go through this, ask our questions and go through that process to make sure finally these families, these people, have an end to something horrible that was brought about by the Post Office in the UK.
Thank you. And the question is that Amendment 13118.1 in the name of Douglas Ross, which seeks to amend Motion 13118 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau on changes to the business programme, be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The Parliament is not agreed. Therefore, we will move to a vote and there will be a short suspension to allow members to access the digital voting system.